It is done. The consoles are out. Next gen is now current gen. So you can all stop fucking saying next gen now. Let's not have a repeat of last time where people were saying it 5 months down the line. And the question on everybody's lips is, who won the console launch? Was it Sony with the PS4? Was it Microsoft with the Xbox One? I just don't know. Oh, wait. I do, because I'm Jim Sterling, what I say goes. So watch this episode and be amazed by the rightness of it all. The Wii U! It's been very, very easy to forget the Wii U with all the attention on the PS4 and Xbox One right now. Microsoft and Sony are bringing powerful machines to the market both at the same time in a climactic head-on clash at a time where Nintendo's system has been out for about a year, long enough for us all to get pretty used to its existence. However, if I were to recommend one system guaranteed to give your kids a good Christmas right now, well, I'd obviously have to say the Wii U. As far as I'm concerned, the most successful launch of this new generation was not the PS4, nor the Xbox One, but indeed the Wii U. I'm interested for the potential of the PS4 and Xbox One on some level, yes, but right now they look just so much like an extension of the last generation. The PS4 and One truly are just incrementally improved PS3s and Xbox 360s. The games, too, are either sequels to last-gen games, or they're full of continuations of less-than-pleasant last-gen trends, like QTEs, handholding, season passes, DLC, firmware installations, and fucking microtransactions. In seeing Sony and Microsoft systems at work, I'm thinking to myself, they're pretty cool. With the Wii U, however, I was genuinely excited for the system. When I plugged it in, I was eager to dive into it, explore, and play with all the new features. The revamped eShop was cool, the Miiverse was hilarious fun, and finding out just how great the gamepad felt in my hands was a fantastic surprise. I'm not exactly down on either the PS4 or the Xbox One, don't get me wrong. They are solid machines, and I hope for a good future generation. Launch libraries, as we've discussed before, and no indicator of future success, how we saw that on the Wii U itself. But the Wii U, in fairness, does have Zombie U, which was fucking great, even if half the people who criticized it forgot what a survival horror game was, and it just launched Super Mario World 3D, which, by all accounts, is fucking incredible. Right now, as people argue who won the next-gen launches out of Sony and Microsoft, I feel Nintendo really does need to be given its due. Sure, the Wii U has had a sleepy year since it launched, but it did have the only launch that made me genuinely excited for the next 5 years, and it does have the best games of what is now the current generation, at least right now, at this crucial pre-holiday moment. Not to mention, the Wii U's currently rocking that apparently so hard to achieve 1080p resolution like a fucking champion. The Wii U has just been the more exciting console for me. It's the one I get excited about most when I think about turning on a system. It's the one I'm eager for excuses to play. It's the one where I can draw pictures of Willem Dafoe and put them in the Rabbids Land Miiverse, which is the place where Willem Dafoe pictures belong, don't let Nintendo tell you otherwise. Really, the Dafoeverse thing should have been a system seller in its own right, if only Nintendo would just officiate it. Come on, Iwata, you know it makes sense. All these things are relative, and the balance could easily shift. I feel sorry for the Wii U, I have to say. I want to just ruffle its hair and tell it it's gonna be okay. History, I feel, will view the Wii U with a kind of pity, and though I don't like to predict hardware performance, I've got a feeling Nintendo will be looking to axe this system far sooner than it ever considered axing the Wii. But right here, right now, looking at what all three systems offer, and if asked to say which one I felt had the most exciting, interesting launch, well, as I said, I'm going Wii U. It didn't have the hype of either the PS4 or the Xbox One. It didn't have the celebrity endorsements and the thrill of the perpetual console wars keeping it in the headlines. It did, however, do one thing the others are yet to do. It inspired wonder. That wide-eyed wonder that should always come with a brand new console, that sense of new things to dig into, explore, and discover. The PS4 and Xbox One, in iterating what previous consoles did, does not have that sense of wonder. It's all very familiar, well-built and good-looking, I totally grant you, but nothing I want to giddily explore in childlike fascination. That's what the Wii U did for me, and I think is what a new console ought to always feel like. So full of surprising newness that it's hard to take it all in at once. Sony and Microsoft gave us stuff we know already, but better. And that's fine, that's cool, but it's no wonder the gaming media seems a little detached and cold in its coverage of the systems. It's all about the games, of course, and once all three systems have a stronger a library of titles, the real comparisons can begin. That'll be a ways off, and I'm eager to see how it'll pan out. But right now, if you want a genuinely fresh and interesting current-gen system with some incredible software, the Wii U's probably gonna make you very happy. At the very least. Hell, the poor little fucking console deserved someone tossing it a bone right now, yeah? You're right, Miniature Fantasy Willem Dafoe. An excellent episode, and everything I said was correct. But you have a point. Perhaps we are missing out one serious contender. Perhaps it's not too late for a challenger to appear. Thank God for me.